Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to update from Windows 10 to Windows 11 using the Windows 11 ISO file. The method I show in this video is one of two methods to update from Windows 10 to Windows 11 and only works on systems where Windows 11 is supported. And I'll link another method to update to Windows 11 at the end of this video, as well as how to update to Windows 11 on unsupported hardware. But starting with the update to Windows 11 using the Windows 11 ISO file, firstly, you'll need the Windows 11 ISO file, and I've made a separate video on how to download the latest Windows 11 ISO file, which I'll link in the description of this video and in the cards now. So once you have this Windows 11 ISO file on your Windows 10 installation, you can go ahead and right-click on it, and then you want to find the option that says Open With. And then you want to choose Windows Explorer. If you don't see Windows Explorer on this list, just click on More Apps and find it on the list of More Apps, and then click on OK. Then the Windows 11 ISO file will open in a new window and you'll be able to see the Windows setup files. Next, you need to launch this setup application. So I'm just going to go ahead and double click on that. If you have user account control turned on, just accept any prompts. And then the Windows 11 installation wizard will launch. Once the Windows 11 setup wizard has launched, you'll see this screen. And here you need to click on this option that says Change How Setup Downloads Updates. And then just change this to Not Right Now. And make sure this box that says I want to help make the installation better is unchecked. Then click on Next. It'll do some checks on your PC. Next, you'll see the license terms. You can read through this if you want. I'm just going to go ahead and click on Accept. It'll do some more checks on your computer to make sure that you're ready to install Windows 11. Once the Windows 11 setup wizard is done with all of its checks, you'll see this screen that says ready to install, and you'll see two options, install Windows 11 and keep personal files and apps. To make sure that you're able to keep your personal files and apps, you need to choose the same language of the Windows 10 version that's currently installed on your computer or that's installed on the computer that you want to perform the upgrade on. For English, there are two versions. There's the English United States version, and then there's an English International version. So if you can't keep your personal files and apps, you'll need to re-download the Windows 11 ISO file, but this time choose the same language that's installed on your computer or the computer that you're trying to upgrade to Windows 11. But once that's done, you can go ahead and click on Install, and then you'll see the first Windows 11 installation screen, and your computer will restart several times during this process, and this can take anywhere from 30 minutes to 2 hours or more, depending on if you have a solid state drive or hard drive in your computer. Once the Windows 10 to Windows 11 upgrade process is finished, you'll see the Windows 11 welcome screen, and then you'll be taken to your lock screen where you'll need to enter your password to log into your account, or you'll be taken straight to the desktop if you don't have any password. And then you can start using Windows 11. And that means the Windows 10 to Windows 11 upgrade process completed successfully, and you can now start using Windows 11 on your computer. I do hope this guide helped you out. Please like the video and watch any of my other helpful videos that's linked on screen now. I'll see you in the next one.